What's up, guys? It's Powerbang. Welcome back to another video. We've got Lineage 2 on deck today. I've partnered up with Netmarble to bring you guys a short strategy series that's going to discuss how you need to start leveling up your account, some things to keep in mind, and we are going to go over several topics, the first of which is clans and why you need to be a part of one now.
This video is sponsored by Netmarble.
That's right, clans are the topic of the day, and as an MMORPG, Lineage 2 Revolution really, really rewards players for being social, for being part of a clan, and we're gonna look at how to join one right now. So the first thing you need to know is you wanna power through the first 10 levels of the game. Go do your quest, follow the prompts on the screen. You gotta get to level 10 to open up the ability to join a clan. Once you're there, you can open up the game's menu, and you'll find the clans button. Click that clan button, click the next clan button, and then you'll get the option to join or create a new clan. Do whichever one you prefer, but for the sake of this video, we're gonna go ahead and look at how to join a clan that already exists. So on the join clan page, there are three tabs, the first of which are the clan rankings. So if you're looking for the biggest, baddest clan around, just look at the top of the rankings and they are ranked in order all the way down. The last tab is the clan invitations, which is where you would receive invites to join a particular clan if you're lucky enough to receive one. Now, the tab we are going to be paying attention to today is the middle tab, which are the recruiting clans. Those are the clans that have in their profile flagged as they are accepting new members. Just make sure that you meet the criteria they describe and go ahead and click join. Now that you've joined a clan, there are so many more options that can help you boost along, speed up your gameplay. Let's get into a few of those now. First, you're going to see the option to actually greet your clan mates. And when you greet them, you're actually going to get a clan coin for that, and it's going to send a little something to them as well. When your clanmates greet you, you can actually collect those and get more clan coins. Clan coins can be used at the clan shop to buy items. These items are things like enhancement scrolls, upgrade stones, rune fragments, summoning stones, elixir essence, clan buffs, and the list goes on and on. Long story short, they're exclusive perks that are only available to members of clans. You can't get these buffs when you're running around solo. The other thing that you want to remember to do and also remind your clanmates to do every single day is to check in. It's simply clicking the check-in button. The more people that do this, the more rewards your clan will receive as individuals. Next up are clan achievements. These are essentially quests that are tracked as a clan. You have to complete them before the timer runs out, so if you do it in a timely manner and everybody contributes to the clan achievement, you actually get individual rewards. Those will be sent to your mailbox. You can collect those, profit from them, and any clan rewards are sent to the clan storage. Speaking of clan storage, you can actually use the items that are stored there to buff up your clan to take on the clan dungeons. Now, these are special clan dungeons that you can jump in with your clan and do once a week for some spectacular reward. At the end of each week, they will reset, can actually be reset once daily if you use red star stones. Red star stones are a currency that you can get while grinding out mobs in high-level dungeons. I really wouldn't recommend going into the clan dungeon solo. Even if you have great gear, it's simply too risky. You've got to use the power of your team in order to power your way through those dungeons quickly, efficiently, and getting rewards for the whole crew. Another huge feature in this game is the Fortress Siege mode. The Fortress Siege is only accessible if you are in a clan. It's a clan versus clan battle where one clan is basically trying to take control of the fortress. 50 versus 50 is the uppermost possibility of this game mode, and the great thing is if you are a member of the clan and everybody's online to take part in these sieges at once, you can actually kind of ride the coattails of some of the upper level players and gear up super, super fast, much more quickly than you would just grinding quests for common gear out in the regular world. We've talked about a ton of things that clans will help benefit new players and new accounts right off the bat. Obviously, the social interaction is super, super beneficial as you progress through the game, and it becomes pretty much imperative at higher levels. But there's still one thing that we gotta talk about, and that is the clan headquarters. Once you get your clan up to level 5, you can access the clan hall. It takes a little bit of clan Adina to unlock it, but once you get there, all kinds of buffs and items are available through the clan hall, including clan quests, as well as solo clan quests that you can get and really, really accelerate the growth of your character. There's even Pan's gifts that are given away daily. All you gotta do is go up to that friendly looking kitten, click receive gift, and as your clan continues to donate to the clan hall, the gifts get better and better. So as time progresses, gifts get better, your character gets stronger, and all of that comes through the clan hall. So that pretty much covers clans, guys. For those of you that are just starting out, don't forget the clan dungeons and the fortress siege modes. Those are absolutely huge for gearing up with huge items very, very quickly. We also talked about the clan store and the clan headquarters. Make sure you guys are checking in on a daily basis, making sure that you're greeting and collecting from all of your clanmates. That's going to get you those coins so you can buy those items in the shop. So guys, if you liked the episode, make sure you smack the like button for me. And if you want to see more Lineage 2 Revolution tips, subscribe to the channel. I've got more strategy guides coming soon. That's going to be all for today though, guys. This is Powerbang signing out. Until next time, take care.